Yeah, Rahul, and today we have to learn about the standard 9 mathematics. Okay, so today we have to learn about the standard 9 mathematics, and today's concept is as per the previous lecture, that is coordinate geometry. That is coordinate geometry. Okay, so as per the previous lecture, we are already learned about the how to represent the column coordinate in the graph. Okay, so in the graph you have to plot a point in the way of x comma y. Okay, you have to plot the point in the graph, that is in the x comma y. For the x we have to tell them x theta, and for the y we have to tell them x ordinate. Okay, so with the combination of x theta and the coordinate, with the help of the x theta and the coordinate, we have to found combination of both of them as a coordinate. We have to find combination of the ordinate and x theta, that is coordinate, and the following coordinates are represented on the graph. Okay, and we already learned that there is a four type of the graph, which are divide the graph in the four types, that is each of one is called as quadrant, and there are the four types of the quadrant are available. In the first quadrant we are always taking plus plus, that is x and y, both of the values are positive. In second quadrant we have to take value of x, that is negative, and value of x y is positive. In third quadrant we have to take value of x and value of y, both of them as a negative. And in fourth quadrant we have to take that value of x as a positive and value of y as a negative. Okay, so as per the previous lectures we have learned about the how to arrange or how to plot the points of the coordinate. Okay, now in today's lecture we are learning about the linear equation. Plot the linear equation, that is with the two variable. Okay, and also in the one variable. Okay, so as per this we know that in the polynomials we already know about the linear equation in one variable and two variables. In the one variable, that's the standard formation is ax plus b is equal to 0, and in the two variable that standard formation is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, x and y both are the variables, and a, b and c are the constant term. Okay, so let's start today's session. Okay, so first question is that find the value of a and b in this equation. Write the value of a and b from the equation. That is, first question is 3x plus 4y plus 5 is equal to 0. So as per this standard formation, what is my value of A? That is, value of A is 3, value of B is plus 4, and value of C is also as a plus 5. Okay students, now second one is 9x minus y equal to 8. Okay, now as per the standard formation, I want that constant term with this equation, therefore I'll shift it on the second side. So my standard formation is formed here. So A is 9, B is minus 1, and value of C is minus 8. Okay, now another example, that is 9x minus 4 equal to 0. Here you saw that there is not any variable with the y. So as per the standard formation, I'll define that as a 9x plus 0y minus 4 equal to 0. In the question, there is not any available of this variable with the y, so I'll put them as a 0y. Every time you have to put the value of 0y whenever that variable are not available. Okay, so my A is 9, B is 0, and C is minus 4. Okay, now we take another example related to that, that is 4y minus 5 equal to 0. In this case, we also found that there is not any variable related to the x, so I'll put x as a 0x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. You must form with this standard formation. Okay, you must form as a standard formation. So what is the value of A? A is 0, B is plus 4, and C is minus 5. Okay, understand? Okay, now we are moving which of the following an equation in two variables x and y. Okay, which of the following are the equation in the two variables x and y? So let's start with the second examples. We are going to the another type of the examples. Okay, now we have to write each of the following in two variables x and y. Okay, so here is the x equal to minus 4. So as per the my standard formation, is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. In that case, you found that there is always two variables available in the formation. So in this case, I don't have any second variable. Okay, so as per the our previous question that I told you, that first of all, move the constant term with the equation. Okay, and second thing, that is, here is not here is not any kind of the variable with the y. So I'll put as a 0y in the question. Okay. So my formation is like this. Okay, students. Now y equal to 3. Y equal to 3. Okay. So as per the y equal to 3, I'll put them as shifted 3 on the second side. So what is the equation? That is y minus 3 equal to 0 are formed. Now as per the standard formation, what I want? I want variable x in this formation, but here is not any kind of the variable x available. So I'll put as a 0 x plus y minus 3 equal to 0. Okay, every time if there is any kind of the variable x or y are not available, so you can put them as the 0x or 0y. Okay, clear? Now we are moving on. Now question is, write the solution of the equation. Now we have to find solution of the equation. So how to find solution of the equation? There is a two variable in the equation, and as per the linear equation we are formed as a ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Okay, now my question is 3x plus 4y. 3x plus 4y is equal to 7. Okay, 3x plus 4y is equal to 7. Now solve them using the value of the different kind of the x or y. Okay, now if I want to solve them, so from both of them variable I choose any one of them and put the values of the x or y as a values, then I'll find the second values of the second variable. If I put the value of x as a 1, 2, 3, 4, so I'll find the value of y in the corresponding with the equation. Or if you want to write the value of y as a 1, 2, 3, 4, then you have to find value of x corresponding to the equation. Okay. So we have to think in both of them cases. Okay. So in first case, I'll put the value of x as a 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now solve them. Now we have to solve them. So as per the equation 3x plus 4y equal to 7, first we have to take value of x as a 1, that is 3 into 1 plus 4y equal to 7. Therefore 3 plus 4y equal to 7. Therefore 4y equal to 7 minus 3. Therefore 4y equal to 4. Therefore y equal to 1. When I put the value of x as a 1, I found that value of y is also equal to 1. Okay, we have to assume any kind of the value of the x or any kind of the value of the y in the first and second case. Okay, any kind of integers, fractions, numericals, natural numbers, whole numbers, any kind of them. Okay. So second, I'll put the value of 2 of x in the equation. That is that I found that 6 plus 4y equal to 7. That is 4y equal to 7 minus 6. That is 4y equal to 1. That is y equal to 1 by 4. When I put the value of x as a 2, then I found the value of y as a 1 by 4. Okay. Now I put the value of x as a 3. 3 into 3 plus 4y equal to 7. 9 plus 4y equal to 7. That is 4y equal to 7 minus 9. That is 4y equal to minus 2. Therefore, y equal to minus 2 by 4. That is 1 by 2. Y equal to minus 1 by 2. So, when I put the value of 3 of x in the equation, so I'll found the value of minus 1 by 2 as a y. And now I put the value of x as a 4, that is 3 into 4 plus 4y equal to 7, that is 12 plus 4y equal to 7, that is 4y equal to 7 minus 12, that is 4y equal to 3 plus 2, 5, that is minus 5, that is y equal to minus 5 by 4. Okay? That is y equal to minus 5 by 4. Okay? This is my solution for this of all. I'll say that solutions of this equation. Okay? If you want to choose y, if you want to choose y and put the value of y in the equation as a 1, 2, 3, 4, then you also found that different kind of the values of x. Okay? You found that different kind of the values of x. Okay? Then I'll take the values of y. Okay? So, in the first case, 3x plus 4y equal to 7, therefore 3x plus 4 into 1 equal to 7, therefore 3x equal to 7 minus 4, therefore x equal to 3 by 3, that is x equal to 1. So, when I put the value of y as 1, so I'll find the value of x as a 1. Now I'll put the value of y as a 2. Therefore 3x plus 4 to the 8 equal to 7. Therefore 3x equal to 7 minus 8. Therefore 3x equal to minus 1. Therefore x equal to minus 1 by 3. Okay? When you take the value of the y as a 2, then you found that value of x is 1 by 3. Okay? Now, I put the value of y as a 3. So, what can I found? I found that 3x equal to 7 minus 12, 3x equal to minus 5, that is x equal to minus 5 by 3. Then I found that value of y is a minus 5 by 3, and for the value of c, when I put the value as a 4 in the place of the y, so I'll find that 3x equal to 7 minus 16, So 7 minus 16, that is minus 9. So therefore minus 9 by 3, that is minus 3. That is x equal to minus 3. Okay. So in both of them, please students, note down that from both of them you have to choose any kind of the one method, not both of them. Okay. Any kind of one method you have to do in the exam or in the fair book or any kind of this statement, you can't do, and you can't do both of them method, okay, at a time. Choose any one of them method. Okay. Here I show you both of the method, because here I show you both of the method, and I'm doing both of the method because I'm showing you that from both of them conditions you found correct answer from both. Okay. Both of them are correct if there are be found. Okay. So in the exam point of view, please do any one of the method. If you choose found the value of x, if you choose the value of x, then you found the value of y, and if you choose the value of y, then you found the value of x. Okay. I'm taking value of x 1 2 3 4, that I'm assuming that value of 1 2 3 4. Okay. You can take any kind of the value of x. Okay. That is integer, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, any kind of. Okay. Now we can solve this type of the sum using word problem. Okay. Here the one question is, if x equal to minus 1 and y equal to 2, if x equal to minus 1 and y equal to 2, if x equal to minus 1 and y equal to 2, if the solution of equation is a solution of equation, equation is that 3x plus 4y equal to k, find the value of k. Find the value of k. Okay. In the question, we found that there is a value of x and y are given. So I put the value of x and y in the equation to find value of k. So therefore 3 into minus 1 plus 4 into 2 is equal to k. So therefore 3 into 1 minus 3 plus 4 to the 8 equal to k. So what do you find the value of k? Then value of k is 5. Value of k is 5. Okay. Now we are moving on this graphically. As per the graphically, I am already given you that whenever we take this linear equation in two variables, that graph shows that straight line in the any kind of this formation or any kind of this quadrant. So your graph will be like straight line as well. Slant line, straight line is parallel to y axis, straight line that is parallel to x axis, any kind of this straight line you have to found. Okay. But there is a must line that we found, that in the linear equation in two variables we must have found that straight line as the in the graph. Okay. Now my question is, draw the graph of the equation y minus x equal to 2. Draw the graph of the y minus x equal to 2. We have to draw the graph of y minus x equal to 2. Then we have to take value of y or x to find the value of similar of the equation. So we have to take any kind of the values. So I put the value of x to following y. So I put the value of x as a 0, 1, 2 or 3. So I found the value of y as a 0, 0 plus 2 is 2, 1, 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 2 is 4, and 3 plus 2 is 5. Okay? So if you put the value of x in the following equation, then you found that value of y as a 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Now, I put the value of x, y, that is 0, 2, 1, 3, 2, 4, and 3, 5. I put the value of this all coordinates in this graph. So as per the previous lecture of the coordinate geometry, we already learned about the how to put the value of x, y coordinates in this graph. So I show you how to put the value of coordinates in this graph. Okay. So your mind is x, that is x dash, y and y dash. So I'll put the value of 0, 2, that is in the x 0 and y equal to 2. Whenever I take the x equal to 0, then point is located on the always y axis that I already told you in the previous lecture. Now take x equal to 1 and y equal to 3. X equal to 1, y equal to 3. Therefore, my point is located here. Okay? Now, second is x equal to 2, y equal to 4. So, my point is located at here. Now, x equal to 3 and y equal to 4. That is, my point is located at here. So, as per the point, I show that with the joining of this point, I found that there is a straight line, formation of this straight line in this graph. Okay? So what can I found? I found this straight line in this graph. Okay? So this equation, I found the line of x line of the straight line in this graph, that is for this y minus x equal to 2. Okay? So using this, you have to do for the today's homework, for today's lesson or today's session, that is solve the following equations using graph or using solution. So please write the homework for the today's session. Okay. For the today's session, your homework is express in the standard formation and indicate the values of the A, B, C and each case. I'll write here that write or found write the equation in standard form and find the value of A, B, and C. Okay? So your question is here, that is, the question is here, is that is 2x plus 3y equal to 5, 2x plus 3y equal to 5, second one is 2x plus 3 equal to 0, y minus 5 equal to 0, and 4 equal to 3x. Okay, now second question is, find two solution of this following equation. That is, write two solutions of this following equations. Okay, two solution means you have to write any, you have to just write value of two, that is 1 and 2, you have to just write value of 2 times, okay, of x, that is first is x minus 6y equal to 0, second is 4x minus 3y equal to 8, and third is 5x minus 2y equal to 10. And the last question is, draw the graph of this equation is x plus y equal to 8. Okay, x plus y equal to 8. Okay, when you draw the graph of the equation, then you must solve or find the solutions of the equation, at least four kind of the solution. Okay, at least four kind of the solution. Okay, so I hope you have to understand all things that I'll teach you in today's session. Okay, so till then, students, goodbye. Okay, and stay.